DM Science and Plants World presents about the primary structure of monocot leaf with the example of grass leaf structure. In previous video, we already discussed about the monocot and dicot stem, monocot and dicot root, and about dicot leaf. To know about those topics, do check the description box to find the link for those videos. So, as I said before, we are going to discuss about the primary internal structure of monocot leaf with the example of grass leaf. The transverse section of grass leaf reveals about the regions like epidermis, mesophyll and vascular bundle. This is the complete structure of grass leaf, which includes the parts like cuticle, upper epidermis, substomatal chamber, mesophyll, bundle sheath, xylem, phloem, that is vascular bundle, and lower epidermis, which has the stoma, that is stomata. So we are going to see about this arrangement of these parts in detail. First, we are going to see about the epidermis. The leaf has upper and lower epidermis. In the picture, here you can find the upper epidermis, and here this one is the lower epidermis. Both the epidermis are usually made up of single layer of thin-walled parenchyma cells, and both the layer is covered out, that is the outer, both the epidermis outer walls are covered by a thick cuticle. Here the stomata number is more or less equal in both upper and lower epidermis, whereas in dicot leaf we already discussed that the number of stomata is more in lower epidermis when compared to the upper epidermis. The stomata is surrounded by a dumbbell shaped god cells. The god cells contains the chloroplast. Chloroplast is a cell organelle which is responsible for the photosynthesis process. Except the god cells, other epidermis cells don't possess the chloroplast. Some special cells surrounded the god cells, and they are distinct from the epidermis cells structure, and that special cells are defined as subsidiary cells. Some of the upper epidermis are larger and thin walled, and that cells are called bulliform cells or motor cells. Here you can find the some large sized cells when compared to the other cells. Here you can find the larger thin walled cells. These cells are represented as bulliform cells or motor cells. These cells are helpful in rolling and unrolling of leaves during the weather change. Already we discussed about the phytis, that is rolling and unrolling of leaf in young leaf. To know about that phytis also, you can check the description box. So this bulliform cells helps to do the rolling and unrolling of leaf. Some epidermal cells of the grass also filled with this component called silica, and those cells are represented or termed as silica cells. The ground tissue that present in between the upper and lower epidermis of the leaf is said to be mesophyll. Here, the mesophyll is not differentiated into palisade parenchyma cells and spongy parenchyma cells as you found in the dicot leaf. Here, all mesophyll cells are nearly isodiametric in size and thin walled, and they are compactly arranged with limited cellular, that is intercellular space. In dicot leaf, you find that more intercellular space found in spongy parenchyma cells when compared to the palisade parenchyma cells. But here, all cells have the limited intercellular space, and they also contain numerous chloroplasts. As I said before, chloroplast is responsible for the photosynthesis process. Here, vascular bundle are different in size. Here you can find three vascular bundle which are different in size. The vascular bundle are smaller in size. Larger bundles are occur at rectangular intervals. Here, two packs of sclerenchyma are present above and below the larger vascular bundle, and this sclerenchyma patches gives the mechanical support. Here in larger bundle you can find the pink colored sclerenchyma cells, Already we discussed that sclerenchyma cells are dead cells in sclerenchyma session also. To know about the sclerenchyma, you can check that link also. So these cells offer the mechanical support. The smaller vascular bundle don't have that sclerenchyma patches. Here the vascular bundle are conjoint, collateral and closed. Conjoint means xylem and phloem are at same radius. So this pink colored cells are said to be xylem cells and this blue colored cells are said to be phloem cells. These occur in same radius. Collateral means even though it occur in same radius, phloem occurs little bit outward, then those vascular bundles are represented as collateral, and closed means the vascular bundle don't contain the cambium cells, which is responsible for the cell division. Here, the vascular bundle is surrounded by the parenchymatous bundle sheath cells. The cells of bundle sheath is generally contains the starch. So this pink colored cells are said to be parenchymatous bundle sheath cells, which stores the starch grains. The xylem of vascular bundle located towards the upper epidermis. Here you can find the two metaxylem and one protoxylem, which directed or direct towards the upper epidermis, and the phloem direct towards the lower epidermis. In C4 grasses, the bundle sheath are living that are involved in the C4 photosynthesis cycle, and that sheath is called trans sheath. So this is about the internal primary arrangement of leaf, monocot leaf, which has the parts like cuticle, upper epidermis, substomatal chamber. So this is the stomata which present in the upper epidermis, and this is the stomata which present in the lower epidermis. Both the stomata, you can find the substomatal chamber or respiratory cavity or air chamber, and mesophyll, which is contains uniform cells, and this is the bundle sheath, and this is the xylem, and this is the phloem, lower epidermis, and this is the cuticle. Thank you so much for watching.